Welcome back, guys, to the next episode of Twilight Princess. After the end of the last episode with a massive fail, where I bring the hot spring water to the Goron, at least we've ended up in kind of the right location to deliver the letter to Telma. So, you know, every cloud has a silver lining. We're going to look at it that way rather than, oh my god, what did you do? But yes, now we're moving on. Telma's bar. I've gone the complete and opposite wrong way. Oh my god. This way for Telma's bar. We're going to deliver the letter and hopefully set out to regain Ilia's memory. Also, repowering our Dominion Rod in the process. We mustn't forget that. I mean, Ilia's memory more important, but Dominion Rod power, pretty useful for picking up some more heart pieces. Hello. I better set that as an item. Bonjour, madame. I have this letter. Ooh, well, if it isn't from Renado, the shaman. All this writing and he doesn't bother to mention a thing about little old me. Honey, that is what I call rude. Well, there's no accounting for the foolishness of a man. At least I understand Ilia's situation now. Of course I can lend a hand for that adorable little girl. What else do I know? The first one to bring Ilia to the shop was that doctor. Maybe he knows something, but he's a crusty old bat, that's for sure. I've got it, honey. You go ahead and take this to him. This magic little paper will get that codger talking. You got the invoice. This invoice is for the town doctor's running tab, which is an astronomical sum. Sent to be, blah blah blah, yakety smackety. It sure would be nice if she started remembering things soon, eh, Oliz? Yes, I'm sure it would be. Well, we got an invoice now. Hello, Melman in the corner. Be more social, beast. Go speak with those guys over there. But where is the doctor? Where is the doctor situated? Doctor who, even? Does he have a name apart from the doctor? Is he trying to rip off a famous doctor? I don't know where to head, so we're going to head left. Because I don't think right is the right way, considering we know what's there. Fortune teller shop. Okay, not there, of course. That's Giovanni's house. I'm kind of puzzled. I've never been to the doctor's house before. Is it in the town? Doctor's house. You've got to kind of have like a little courtyard area or entryway. Doctor's house. Ah, what are you? Medical clinic. Lovely. We're here. That dog is still fawning over us like, ah, I love bones. I just don't like streets because they're made of concrete and it hurts. Hello, old codger. Eh, what's that? Just as I wondered who it might be, I see it's the admirable young lad who's willing to help the Zora boy for nary a single rupee. Just what is it you want, lad? A physical? You've some money, don't you? By the way, that girl Ilia didn't mention anything about me, did she? Why would she? Why would she, sir? Here's something to look out of your glasses. Ah! Look, I can't pay this off right now. I can see Telma's hired you as some sort of heavy to strong arm me, but she'll have to wait. Look, lad, if I'd been able to sell the wooden statue that young lady had, I would have been able to get the money. Hello, what are you trying to do, sell stolen goods? But see, I accidentally spilled medicine all over that little carving, which made it stink awfully. I put it outside to dry, but then, well, it was stolen. You stole it first? Who goes around stealing people's stuff like that? Hello? What a world. You always have to be on guard, eh? I look, Mr. Heavy. At any rate, neither the money nor the carving is here, so I can't repay you. Now to work, to work. Ah, you're going to reveal something by moving out the way, aren't you, sir? I'd imagine there should be a heart piece somewhere around it. Aha! Aha! Revealed something or other. Is that where you spilt the medicine, sir? Well, we know something that can get sense. Mainly taught to us after the reek fish incident. The three times fished up reek fish. Let's have a sniff. Forget the reek fish scent and learn a new smell. You learn the medicine scent. Boo! Boo! You're a persistent little bugger. I said I have neither the money nor the wooden statue, you great lout. I can't return what I don't have. Look around. Oh, I can't get rid of that medicine stench. I don't have any money. When it rains, misfortune, it pours. Remember that, lad. Stop stealing people's stuff, then. So where are we headed? Up and out there? I wasn't expecting that. Well, if you were looking for money, sir, and you needed money, you've got some on your balcony, which is now mine. From one thief to another. Any jars or chests belong to me, no matter where they are, in your house or whatnot. Open the chest, wolf boy. 20 rupees, thank you for more of your money, sir. Now, the scent goes down the street, which means to follow it, I'm going to have to be in wolf form in the town at daytime. So there might be knights trying to kill me, but whatever. Hi, guys. Well, knight, you're not very good if you just let me walk past. Let's follow the scent. To the statue! Stop screaming. Have I never harmed you before? It doesn't even look like I'm slightly vicious, does it? Is he not even going to chase after me? What a useless knight. It looks like we're going back to Telma's bar. Ah, the kitty kit. You're looking for the wooden statue that Ilia had, aren't you, dear? Think it's a coincidence that I happen to know it got stolen from the doctor's place? No. Yes, I'll admit it, I took it, but then I was attacked by some sort of skeletal dog beast who took it from me. I don't know why those beasts were after a statue, I thought it likely that she was in a dangerous spot, though. Those fiends lurk just outside the southern gate, unfortunately they only come out at night. And another thing, they always move around as a pack. You won't get that statue back unless you give them all a thrashing. The statue sounds like a key to getting Ilia's memory back, you must get it back. South Gate, so back to our scene of our gore and failings. We've got to wait for it to turn to night time. Really? The Goron doesn't even look remotely scared, but you guys are cowering for your lives. Well, the Goron's a manly man. Plus, he's really big. Could probably smoosh me. So that leads me to an annoying point of time where I literally have to mill around here for a little bit until, well, until nighttime comes. So what can we do out here, I wonder? Anything to find? Anything to do? I guess kill some crows and try to get rupees from them. That's not a bad idea. There's a golden bug around here, isn't there? I can hear a tinkle. We already caught you. A female ladybug. Yes, we already did catch you. Short memory, but give me a heart. Fill up my heart, Mia. That's fine by me. The other ladybug should be out here as well if we caught that one. They are in the same area, I do know that. So when you catch one, the other one is nearby. It's just the fact that I'm not very attentive to picking up things, am I? So I guess we just move around until we hear a tinkle-tinkle noise. Until it turns to night. That's an odd quest to do, isn't it? Right then, let's go through every kind of flower. Okay. No noise. Rupees, no. This is an odd search. Because I'm so cool that I can twirl my sword. Hooray. Oh, ladybug, ladybug, ladybug. Where art thou? Where art thou indeed? Hidden in a corner somewhere? This is very annoying. If I talk, then I can't hear the tinkle-tinkle noise. But I have to talk because I'm commentating a video! So yeah, that makes little sense, doesn't it? I can't hear any little tinkles. Or see anything, even though I kind of thought I did. Maybe it's over that location where the crows are. Or maybe it's over by Goron fella. We still need to figure out how to get you your spring water. But I think I might have a solution for you now. Probably is a full-on side quest. No noises? It's turning nighttime, it seems. Land is being split. Oh no, wait, that's just clouds. That's just clouds, we gotta wait a bit longer. Even though I have to get the sword back out again, I just thought I'd do that. Oh, one of the ones that keep living. Oh, loads of ones that keep living. Get away from me, crow boy. You can come for me all you want. I'm looking for ladybugs. Out of my way. Oh, ladybug, where art thou? Don't run into walls. It's not very good flying, is it? The rock we crumpled earlier is still crumpled. Where on earth is this ladybug? It should be nearby. Pick up a ladybug! Ladybug! I see you, ladybug. Come back down, ladybug. We found you in the end. What the hell? That was a shot. Well in front. There we go. Got him in the end. Stop trying to dive on me. Do you guys ever die? I've got a ladybug I need to pick up. So he was in this bunch of flowers. Is he still there? Ladybug, where are you? I can hear you tinkling. I just can't see you now. Where are you, ladybug? It will not stop you from my quest to find the ladybug. Ah, rupees. Yes, jolly good, but ladybug! It is finally turning night now, so we can go get those hounds as well. That ladybug, however, is my first concern. I do not want to miss it now I'm here for it. Oh, ladybug, 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 where did thou go? We found you and then you abandoned us. I can still hear you tinkling whenever I go near here. Really nearby. Did you go on top? Is that a possibility? You went up, you got away from us by going up? Really close by. Oh, there he was. He was on the blooming vines. Should have been handy because I could have hookshot him down. Where you go? Oh, I saw you. Ah, ladybug, ladybug, ladybug. Wait, you were right there. Where did you go again? Why do I have to chase a ladybug around? This is so humiliating. Where have you gone now, ladybug? Might be easier to see you at night if I just wait a bit. Are you back on the vines? There you are. You're flying around. How annoying. We got a remedy for you, sir. It's called the Gel Boomerang. I will have you. You will be mine. Where'd you go again? Stop moving. I'm here. Yes, we got the ladybug at last. It took 10 years, but we got there in the end. But I already got you! But I'm sure I didn't have you already! What's going on here? We have... That's a pill bug! Ah! Ah! I've been chasing the ladybugs despite the fact I've already got the ladybugs! What on earth have I been doing all this time? Oh well. That's 2 failed episodes in a row. But it's not so much of a horrifically bad fail, considering the fact that the monsters are about to appear. We've successfully wasted the time by going on a completely fruitless quest. Good thing, I guess. Now, where are you, sir? This is the Southern Gate. Where are you, skeleton dogs? Hello? Come at me as you like, sirs. I have a sword, and I'm pretty kick-ass. And you give a lot of rupees as well, which I quite like. Spin attack! Oh, the other ones are dead as well. I have to keep moving around the front to spawn more of you. How big a pack do you have? And there's our wooden statue. This oddly shaped statue once belonged to Ilia. It's a clue to restoring Ilia's memory. Okay, we gotta show it to her, so off to Kakariko Village. After the massive fail quest for the ladybugs, which I mistook for pill bugs because I'd afford ladybugs, but pill bugs, it looked more like a buggy bug, and I have no excuse really. It's just going really badly lately, isn't it? Hopefully you guys get a couple of laughs out of it. Let's put it that way. Let's head back to town. See Ilia. It was a successful diversion in which I got more rupees. Let's put it that way. I may have not got another golden bug, but I got more rupees. Changing back to normal Link, let's move on. Hopefully the door is still open at this time. Yep. I mean, I have literally saved the world from Twilight at this point in time, so it's no reason it really should be shut. So, let's Let's bring out the statue, which looks more like some kind of pepper mill or salt mill. Ilia, we have this. What is this? I remember something and was confined somewhere. Yes, and I was saved by whoever was confined with me. And when that person set me free, they gave me this statue. Yes, I remember that much, but that means that person is still in trouble. Oh, what is wrong with me? I can't remember where that place was. I remember! Why do you remember? I thought I had seen that before somewhere. That belonged to the tribe that protected the Hylian royal family long ago. Here we go. They worked in secret, so they lived in a lonely, forgotten place, but I heard that tribe dwindled in the prolonged wars. If you want to find that hidden village, look for a path leading to the Nehru province on the far side of the Bridge of Eldin. But a rock site blocked the way to the village long ago, so you can't get there anymore. I kind of recognize where this might be now. What? Oh, I do not mean to worry you, little human. Problems like these are not problems to Gorons.
Grr.
Go on, Guile the Goron. Our patriarch, Darbus, will be waiting for you up ahead. Look at your map to see where. I would try to find the path beyond the Bridge of Eldin that leads to the neighboring province. It's where I picked up a heart piece through the rail system, if I remember correctly. So back out on the trail again. Who's around at this time of night, I wonder, in the town? No one is at all. It would be nice if there was a sun song in this game. If there was some kind of, you know, way to easily change between night and day. It would be very, very handy indeed. Let's put it that way. So, let's get a pony ready. And head off. Our faithful horse fella. Let's go. They should really put one dungeon in the series that relies on you being on or with Epona for the whole of it. Just to add more depth to the character that is Epona. More use than just a riding horse. Not saying Epona's not badass and brilliant in all the Zelda games that she appears in. But still, it'd be nice to have that kind of dynamic. A man and his horse battling for the future of mankind and everything else. I got my bow and arrow ready. Time to pass the horrific place that is this field full of enemies. What is this? Golden bug! I see you. Except now I'm in the problem where To get this golden bug, I have to engage in massive fights forever and ever. But you're right, maybe I should just use my sword. Why don't I just use my sword? Don't hit me, birdie guy. I'm trying to shoot you so much. I got that guy so nicely. Me and you are going around in circles and we're not actually managing to engage each other. Get off that horse. Old warthog or whatever. I need to get off that myself. I'm never going to stop this bird chasing me. I'm going to have to get off and fight it man on man. How come you guys aren't dead yet? Run away all you like, sir. Oh, I nearly messed that up. Living Wii remote not on screen. Don't you dare hop up. You're fast. Oi! Oi! Stop. I want to catch you. No! That's it. Bring out the cheat weapons. It's right there, pick it up. And that's the other grasshopper, another bug down. So guys, I'm gonna end this episode here before the monsters suddenly appear again. Thank you guys for watching me fail in picking up ladybugs, but continue on with the main story nonetheless. It was just a period of time I needed to waste to change it to nighttime, but you got to watch a fail, and I hope you got a laugh out of it. Thank you for watching this episode. Tune in next time. I will see you guys around.